Kuzi, what was your reaction to the three-game suspension handed down today?
Oh, I mean, you know, I agree to the suspended, and, you know, I have anything to add to the statement I just released, and, you know, I want to say thanks to this organization, to PA, to NHL, then for their support, and, you know, to the fans. There is a lot of people who are supporting me, and, you know, I'm going to appreciate that, and be as the hockey player, the only chance I can say thanks to them that proven the ice, you know, and growing as a person, I want to get better, and, you know, I'm going to learn from this for sure.
What do you feel like you've learned this summer?
I learned how to be father of the two child. You know, I got the born baby 3 months ago, and, you know, I stay off the social media a little bit. I spend more time with my family, with the kids, and, you know, I just trying to focus more on the practice, and, you know, it's been kind of hard to prove some people something when you're in the summer, because we don't have a hockey game, and only thing I can do best is play hockey.
Kuzi, is this, in your mind, a one-time occurrence, a one-time mistake, or do you, or did you have a
I
problem?
I think I said everything in a statement already, and, like I said, I want to move forward, and, like I said, I want to say more than thanks to my teammates, to the organization for their support, but there is not a word in the language that means more than thanks, right? But I can do more, prove that there was the support for a reason to be downtown every night and do my best for the team.
Kuzi, how do you stay on the right path from now going forward?
That's easy. I mean, you know, there is some people look for motivation right in their life, and there is always challenges in your life, and, you know, for me, this opportunity is pretty clear. Then I can prove a lot of people that I'm still a pretty good player.
Max said the other day that maybe you have to earn back the trust of your teammates, and that maybe you'd address the team. Have you done that? Do you plan to do that?
I think that stays in the kitchen, whatever I'm gonna do in the team and whatever I did already. So, you know me, I'm not a bad guy, so I always worry if I did the mistake during the game. I always worry about little things, and like I said, I very appreciate the support. Even the people who put some negative stuff, I still appreciate them, because their opinion is very important for me also right now.
Kuzi, did any off-ice issues affect your on-ice performance last year?
Oh, no, probably not. I mean, of course, after 70 points, bad year, I look for the bounce back, right? And, you know, and I'm look forward to this year. And like I said, there is a lot of things that I can do on the ice. There is not much I can do off the ice to say thanks to people who are supporting me.
At this point, is it to miss the opener, to miss the home opener, you know, big games early in the year?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, I accept whatever the penalties for me, just to move forward and forget about everything that's happening before. And it was pretty hard summer for me. And like I said, it was like, I've been dreaming about the first day of the camp, so I can be with the team. I can send a message by my body language to all the people. You know, whatever is happening in your life, you just still respect the people, and you treat the people with respect.
Was this difficult when you got the news about the failed test and having to kind of face up to some things with people here, with your family, anything like that? Was that difficult to deal with? Or?
I mean, like I said, there's a lot of people who supported me and everything happened in my life, but that was pretty hard summer for me, like I said. But you know me, I always smile, and whatever is happening in my life, I always look forward. And like I said, I think my wife delivered the second child for me, that was like huge in this summer, because I did spend a lot of times. And like I said, I stay off the media, I stay off the social media. I'm just, if you can say that, lock myself in the gym and just enjoy this time.
Was that your idea to delete the social media?
Yeah, I mean, it's...
Why?
I don't know. It just feels like I spend a lot of time over there. I see watching some pictures, get so addicted to some comments to people, you know. Like I said, I was focusing more on spending the time with the family, with the kids, and just get away from that. And, you know, it's actually pretty nice to stay away from that. And once in a while, I do get open some news, some whatever ESPN, just to check some score. But pretty much I was off the social media all summer.
Kuzi, do you feel like it's been easier moving forward, especially with training camp, starting to focus mainly on hockey?
Yeah, it is. Like I said, I've been dreaming about the first day of the camp because, you know, it's kind of hard practice by yourself. And, all the talks around, it's hard to prove something in life, be the hockey player. The only thing I can do best is play hockey. And like I said, after the very disappointing season, 70 points, I'm looking for a bounce.
Kobe said he called you. What has been the support from teammates? How have they helped since you've been
there? You know, I would like to share that, but like I said, it's more private information. And like I said, for me, it means a lot when people actually send a message, say something, and I'm not a bad person. I'm always remember the things that people did good for me, even best player or not the best player, it's still, I feel that the way the people treat me, and I'm gonna give them back more than they give me.
Not getting to play for Russia, is that something you're going to miss as a player?
I mean, yeah, but like I said, I wanna move forward, and whatever is happening, I cannot change anything.
Two more questions.
After the video was on social media, your statement said that you had never used drugs. Do you kind of regret how some of that was worded on your part?
That's a nice question, you know. No, I'm sorry, but I cannot add anything more. Like I said, I want to move forward, and the only thing I can do best is to play hockey. And I feel bad for my friends, for my teammates, for the organization, for the fans, that they have to deal with this news. But I will pay back more than people give me right now.
Do you feel like you have to change the way you approach the season? As you said, you're a guy who always likes to smile, but do you feel like you have to take this season
No. Like I said, the whole I want to change that's to bounce back from 70 points here.
Boy or a girl?
Boy. Thank you for asking this.
Name?
Yeah, Fedor. And he's not going to be professional athlete also. he'll be one of you guys.
Sorry.
Yeah, I don't really want to wish that a little bit better. No.
I need some friends in your side.
Was there any inspiration for the name?
Yeah, I mean, there's a couple choices in my list, but you know how Ward's wife always figured it out quicker than, you know. And I kind of like that Fedor name, and it's pretty traditional Russian name. And my daughter also having a pretty traditional Russian name. It's not easy to pronounce here in the U.S., but you know, the people get more than heard about.
Last question.